Hi, I'm Jay Kitchener. I'm a senior technical staff member here at IBM Cloud and the lead architect for IBM Cloud Satellite, an exciting product that we have available for you now in IBM Cloud. What is IBM Cloud Satellite? IBM Cloud Satellite is a platform service that allows us to expand the reaches of IBM Cloud to infrastructure outside of IBM Cloud data centers, a powerful new technology. If you want to be able to consume cloud services, but you need to be able to use it closer to your data, where that may be in your on-premises data center, on another cloud provider where you may have a data lake, or potentially it's sitting on your desk like I have right here. Today, I've got three Intel NUCs that I'm gonna be using to set up a satellite location, which I think is pretty cool. It's kind of like any sort of store or kiosk that you might need to set up. And it's a great example of the power of using distributed cloud with IBM Cloud Satellite. So to get started, the first thing I need to do is log into the IBM Cloud console and navigate over to IBM Cloud Satellite. Once I'm there, I'm gonna go ahead and create a new location to represent my desk. I'm gonna go ahead and click the Create Location button, give this location a name, and click Create. Pretty straightforward. Now, once that location is up and running, what I need to do is bring some of my infrastructure on board. To do that, I'm going to navigate over to the host section, which is the concept that we use in IBM Cloud Satellite to represent the idea of systems that are outside of IBM Cloud as the host. The first thing I need to do is click on Attach Host. I'm going to go ahead and download this post-provisioning script. And then once I've got that in my hand, I can go apply that post-provisioning script to any system on the planet. That could be in another cloud provider, it could be in your on-premises data center, or in this case, I want to get it bootstrapped onto these Intel NUCs that are sitting on my desk. Now, to do that, I've built a custom image that will automatically carve up these systems into virtual machines and bootstrap them with my post-provisioning script. So all I need to do is get this onto that USB key, insert it into my Intel NUCs, and go ahead and power them on. Now I'm going to go and go through that process for all three of these because I want a highly available setup so I can do maintenance by removing these later on. But that's pretty much it. Now that those systems are online, we can see they're all up here and ready for me to use in my satellite location. And I'm going to go ahead and get one from each of those systems assigned to be my satellite control plane. This is really the heart of IBM Cloud Satellite that allows us to build a secure way for us to go manage cloud services into your IBM Cloud Satellite location. Now, I've got these hosts assigned, my location is in a normal state, and I'm ready to start using IBM Cloud services. Let's go ahead and take a look at what that experience is like. I'm going to navigate over to the IBM Cloud catalog, and I could choose any of the IBM Cloud Satellite enabled services that we have available. Today, we're going to demonstrate Red Hat OpenShift on IBM Cloud, but it could be other services as well, like our Postgres database or potentially maybe some of our Cloud Pak for Data as a Service options as well. So let's go ahead into the catalog to Red Hat OpenShift on IBM Cloud. And we can see I still have my traditional cloud service options where I can provision into IBM Cloud data centers like a VPC, but I've also got the satellite option available to me as well. So I'm going to go ahead and choose satellite, choose my new location I created, and go ahead and give that a name, and then create that OpenShift cluster. Now, I can navigate over to my OpenShift clusters in IBM Cloud, and we can see I've got a number of clusters in here. Some of them are located in IBM Cloud, some of them are in satellite locations, but this one is on my desk. Let's go ahead and see what that looks like. I'm going to click over to my cluster here, and I can see I've got all the normal service options that I would have for Red Hat OpenShift and IBM Cloud. I can update the version of this cluster to the latest version of Red Hat OpenShift, or I can go in and perform maintenance on my worker nodes as well, like providing updates to them. But the really powerful tool is that you've now got Red Hat OpenShift as a service running in infrastructure in your data center, or in this case, on my desk. I get the standard user experience with single sign-on from IBM Cloud into Red Hat OpenShift, and all the usual tools that I would find in Red Hat OpenShift are available. I've got all of my logging tools, my monitoring tools, the registry, all of the development tools that are available to users of Red Hat OpenShift. So, very powerful tool that we've got available to us here that allows us to really expand the reach of IBM Cloud and the powerful cloud services that we provide. In this case, on my desk, but remember, it could be on any infrastructure in the world running Red Hat Enterprise Linux. Thank you for watching. If you have questions, please drop us a line below. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, please like and subscribe.